Jump toward the decline and keep pressing jump and action keys to climb. Any slope sector becomes climbable, and I can even grab and shimmy to reach other sectors. Do a side jump and press action key to grab on edges passing over an obstacle. I'll talk later about some applications of those new moves on climbable walls. Do a side jump and press action key to grab on edges passing over an obstacle. Do a side jump and press action. You'll be able to grab on climbable walls. Now here's a tricky one. I have a climbable wall above my head. I can use a backward jump. Do a backward jump and press action key to grab on this climbable wall. I can jump from a climbable wall to another using a backward jump and pressing action. To grab on the second climbable wall before I fall down. I can curve while going down a decline. This is what happens normally. And this is what happens if I use my rockets, pressing directional arrows.
that's an Hypercube. It is a 4D cube, also known as Tesseract.
What was that robot, Psiko? It came out from nowhere exactly when I picked up the time flux specimen from the Hypercube.
I do not know, Lara. This is the second time I see one of those robots. The only thing I know is that they name themselves Eternals, and that they live in a dimension called Hyperuranium.
And so what is this for?
You'll learn later about what the time flux specimen is for. But for now, Lara, I have another gift for you. I am sending to you a new device, a PLS you can use every time and everywhere, as long as you wish.
Thank you. when we travel, when we watch still at a TV program, when we study or sit on a bench. We always, during our lives, travel in the space-time continuum. Because we occupy a 3D position in the 3D world, and the time goes by in the wild. This means that any of our travels can be drawn in a graphic that represents the variations of our positions in the space during the time. But the space-time continuum is curved, or, as we usually say, it is warped by the gravitation or by the momentum, which is a quantity that depends by our mass and our speed. The warped space-time continuum, so, can be so distorted in a way that in some cases it has holes created by huge quantity of mass. Those are black holes. Using a gravitation controller, I created a way to pass through those holes, cancelling the tidal effect and taking advantages by space-time tunnels as shortcuts among different areas of the continuum. They are wormholes, that is, links that connect very far areas so that they are reachable in a faster time. A hyperlink is a great instantaneous shortcut to reach those very far places in the space-time continuum that normally will need ages to reach. An example of a warped continuum is the Möbius string. It is curved and bent, and going always in the same direction, you'll expectize an endless world, because you'll come back in the initial position, but in a different moment. So, in a universe like that, you can work forward in the same direction, but you'd come back to where you come from.